जो मैंने किया अगर वो 5 मिनट भी बात करता ना, तो तब तक ये लोग वो मकान को ध्वस्त कर चुके होते, महिला को घसीट कर उसकी इज्जत भी बाहर ध्वस्त कर गए होते और मकान भी ध्वस्त कर दिया होता। ये लोग अपने बॉसेस को खुश करने के चक्कर में ये जनता को कीड़े मकोड़ों की तरह मानने लग जाते हैं, और उसी का विरोध दर्ज कराने के लिए मैं वहाँ पर पहुँचा था, और वहाँ पर उस कार्रवाई को रोकने के लिए फिर ये घटनाक्रम घटा।
The furious Prime Minister Modi today expressed his displeasure with Akash Vijayvargiya.
So tough words, but will action be taken? There's precedence to prove that action has not been taken. Let's quickly put this to a short duration discussion right here on Trending at 10. Dr. Geeta Bhatt, academician and political analyst, is with us. Akash Banerjee, an author as well as a political satirist, is also with us. We have Jitu Patwari, he's a cabinet minister in the Madhya Pradesh government. He's also with us. And also joining us this evening, Amrita Bhinder, the National Executive Committee member of the Bharatiya Janata Yuva Morcha. Akash, I want to begin with you. When we say that the Prime Minister is talking tough, of course he is. I think any sane person is going to say exactly this. But then that is not matched with action on the ground. Do you think that's the real problem? Not the words, but the action.
And I'd just like to add that here is a man who can really take a lot of action. There is nobody stopping him. There is no coalition government. There is no compulsion. There is no 10 Janpath sitting over his, her head. But you started the show with saying that this has happened once before. And you obviously talked about the whole Pragya Singh episode where the Prime Minister said, I will not be able to ever forgive her. And nothing came out of that. But Sanket, this is a problem that has happened much before that. I take you to 2016, where the Prime Minister in a town hall made the biggest tongue lashing on Gaurakshaks. And I quote, I feel very angry because of the cow protection business. Some people have opened shops in the name of cow protection. Some people indulge in antisocial activities at night and become Gaurakshaks during the day. State government should act against such people. This is the Prime Minister in 2016, I'm quoting from Hindustan Times, in a town hall making this announcement. I have never heard any firmer words against Gaurakshak from anybody in the administration. And this came from the Prime Minister. But type Gaurakshaks and you would get 25th of June, two cow vigilante violence, two thrashed by a mob. So there is, of course, the words, and the words are welcome. But they have to be now backed by action, because we are getting international condemnation. This is not about politics anymore. This is the image and reputation of India, Sanket, that we are talking about. Okay. And I think it's time that the Prime Minister really walks the talk on these issues, and there is nobody stopping him.
Okay. Let me quickly take other opening comments also. I've got Amrita Bhinder and Dr. Geeta Bhatt as well. Amrita, we'll come to you first. How do you respond to this criticism? See, it's bad enough that the Prime Minister has to remind his party men and women that this is unacceptable, harsh words being used. What is sadder still is that even now, even after him saying that there should be action, though it should have come immediately on that day, even now there is no action against him. There is only talk.
Sanket, let me be very clear right now that I am with the youth wing organization, and I can tell you the youth of India is not going to be tolerant towards arrogance by any MLA or member.
Well,
of
the MLA is also a representative of the youth. He's a young MLA.
Yeah, exactly, and this is not going to fly. So, in fact, I think he's, whether it comes today or it comes later, let me tell you that there's public condemnation. It is condemnation by the Prime Minister. And I think the Prime Minister's reputation probably is on the block right now.
Because he has condemned this person. And if something comes out of it, then you have to understand it's the largest party. And the Prime Minister can only so much as say this. It is for the committees to decide. But it is also his reputation on the line. So everybody should stand.
Very well said.
And the point of Akash, you must also let me assure you.
Very well said.
That when it was being said about the cow smugglers or any of the cow protection issues, all people are behind bars. There's not one person roaming free right now.
So no, one moment. Amrita, you make the point about Gaurakshaks. My point is, with a comment like that, that should have served as a deterrent. The idea is not to catch people. That message was to those people who were Gaurakshaks, who in the name of the cow were carrying out acts of vigilantism. That has not come down since 2016. No,
there has been cow vigilantism and cow smuggling as much. It's one thing to say when you say these words like there are cow protection. This is not a religion issue. This is a law and order issue.
Okay.
When you have both communities, by the way, have lost people. In fact,
okay.
The minority
okay. Tell you what. This show today is less about cows and more about the bat. So Jitu exactly. Patwari as well as Dr. Geeta Bhatt. Jitu, I want to come to you. You're a minister in the Madhya Pradesh government. The Congress party has been accused in the past on a number of occasions of high-handedness. In a previous debate where you and I were there, your government was accused. Kamal Nath himself was accused of high-handedness. How would you respond? Is this a very politician thing? I know I'm generalizing, but how do you look at action and words?
जहाँ तक प्रधानमंत्री जी का सवाल है इस बात को लेके कि उन्होंने जो निर्णय लिया, जैसे अभी आकाश ने भी कहा और अमृता ने भी अपनी बात कही, मैं मानता हूँ कि एक इनिशिएटिव लेना इसको पॉजिटिविटी से लेना चाहिए, पर जरूरी है इस बात का कि प्रधानमंत्री ने इससे पहले भी कितनी बार ये बोला, वो चाहे अभी काऊ का बात आए कि जितने भी हमारे गो रक्षकों ने जिस तरीके से अपने वायलेंस किए जगह जगह, उनको लेकर भी प्रधानमंत्री जी ने वक्तव्य दिया था. फिर अभी प्रज्ञा ठाकुर को लेकर भी प्रधानमंत्री जी ने वक्तव्य दिया था. महात्मा गांधी के हत्यारे को महिमा मंडित जब हो रहे थे तब प्रधानमंत्री जी की मैं माफ नहीं कर सकता दिल से वर्डिंग थी, और अब इस तरह की वर्डिंग आई है. पर इससे पहले अगर इतिहास देखें तो उन्होंने दो तीन बार जो बोला वो क्लियरिटी कुछ उस पर एक्शन दिखा नहीं. प्रधानमंत्री की बात में उतना वजन नहीं दिखा.
दिस इज वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट. Jitu Patwari, आपका ये कहना है that the Prime Minister's words ring hollow, that he does not carry the words do not carry that weight, which they must.
This time, Sanket, Pradhan Mantri very big majority in देश country in देश assembly country assembly. So Pradhan Mantri का रास्ता क्यों देखना पड़ा बीजेपी को, उससे पहले क्यों नहीं कार्रवाई हुई, सवाल ये भी है.
Okay, Geeta Bhatt, I want to come to you. See, two or three things that have been spoken about here. Number one, why does it, number one, have to take the Prime Minister to remind his men and women that you have to behave yourself? Number one, this act of brazening it out, he seems to suggest that that is not acceptable. And even after that, you do not really have action. And there is precedence to what I'm trying to say in the case of Pragya Thakur. Let me remind you that on the 17th of May, the BJP formed a disciplinary committee, transferred the matter and said that in 10 days we'll come up. She has to reply in 10 days and then we will come up with a response. The response was supposed to come on the 27th of May. Today we are sitting on the 2nd of July. I do not know what is happening in the BJP with regards to that case. Where is the action?
Well, Sanket, you see, the fact remains that, you know, a leader is the one, you know, who guides by self-example. And for any, either it is a political party or whether it is any institution or whether it is in any institution, you know, the head of the institution, his conduct, his word, you know, that is the one which actually decides the kind of a conduct, whether it is work ethics or whether, you know, it is the moral conduct that gets decided, you know, the kind of a conduct which will be present in that organization or that institution.
Okay.
Now, again and again, you know, the Prime Minister, you know, who has again and again gone and has got a massive mandate because he is the one who has always stood against those that, you know, just taking power or getting power does not mean that you misuse it. And if anyone tries to do it, if whether they misuse the power or the kind of a culture of sycophancy, which he has again and again said that it is the Congress culture, you know, which should not seep into the organization. And that is what he was talking about. And I think any organization which has the capacity to introspect,
I allege at this moment, Geeta Bhatt,
is able to come out, unlike to, you know, Sanket, no one is, you know, you look at what is happening in Congress. I mean,
no, I will not look at Congress
the
right
kind
now.
Of, you know, it is the party is in shambles.
The person who lifted that badge was a BJP MLA.
Nothing is happening in the Congress. Just give me 10 seconds. I have waited very patiently. Now the point is that, you know, I mean, Mr. Jitu Tiwari ji just spoke, you know, about cow vigilante and so. Please remind him that in Rajasthan, the Congress government had put an FIR on the deceased Pehlu Khan. Because after all, no one is justifying that. But the fact remains that cow killing is illegal. And smuggling
okay,
of
one
beef
moment. This
is illegal.
Debate is about
is
the bat
it is
brat.
The duty of the state. The duties of the state
okay,
is
Geeta
to
Bhatt,
make sure
the duties
that
of the state,
kind of
the duties also of the organization,
and if they are
and
not
I
able
will tell
to
you, Geeta Bhatt, one moment.
Then the state is also responsible.
Let's not make
just
this
like
a shouting match.
For looking after its citizens.
Dr. Bhatt, I don't want to outshout you, but now
no,
here I want to give
to
you
speak.
A study
I
in contrast.
So
now, one moment, Dr. Geeta Bhatt, very politely, I want to give you or present to the viewers of NDTV a study in contrast. Let's put those graphics up on the screen. There's a gentleman, an Uttarakhand MLA of the BJP called Mr. Kumar Pranav Singh Champion. He was accused on the 23rd of June of misbehaving with journalists, of indiscipline, gross indiscipline. Do you know what action was taken against him? He has been suspended from the party for 3 months. Immediately. Now that's what I call action. And this is a study in contrast in your own party. And I compare it to this case where 1 week on, and despite the Prime Minister saying in as many words, there is no action. So Dr. Bhatt, I again come back to the point. I will shut up the day there is action. I will keep speaking because there is no action and there are only words. Dr. Bhatt, how do you respond to this study in contrast? We'll put those graphics in just a short moment.
Thank you.
Sanket,
जी एक सेकेंड गीता भट्ट के लिए दिस वॉज फॉर डॉक्टर भट्ट फर्स्ट
कैन आई कम इन
या आई मीन व्हाट कैन व्हाट इज एप्लीकेबल टू प्रणव चैंपियन
दैट इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई एम सेइंग नो नो यू सी देयर हैव बीन मेनी सच इंस्टेंसेस बट यू नो व्हाई इज इट दैट नो वन क्वेश्चंस नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल फ्रॉम घोसी There is, you know, there is a member of parliament who got elected who is absconding by the name of Mr. Atul Rai from Bahujan Samaj Party. Now, this person is absconding because the police is after him because he is a rape accused. You know, there is a warrant against him. Have I seen
Are you comparing
any channel
BJP
coming
to Bahujan
out
Samaj
and
Party?
Talking about it and debating
Counter
and,
question.
And an insult a
Akash, Akash
no, I am
he
trying
wants to come
tell
Akash,
you
quickly.
That there are certain...
BJP offered itself as an alternative.
That there are certain organizations who are ready to introspect and question any misconduct.
Yeah, I'm just saying. One moment, Dr. Bhatt. Akash and then Amrita and then Jitu. Akash, one moment, Akash. Akash, before you answer.
Sanket,
I feel that there is an issue in the Bhartiya Janata Party.
When people are comparing the actions and the omissions and the commissions in the BJP to what is happening in the BSP, is the Bharatiya Janata Party the largest and the one of the most powerful political parties in the
it
world
is
going to compare with what the BSP
the
is doing I mean
so
what
selective.
Is what are
a,
what are we talking about so
to,
first and foremost let's change the parameters here the parameter
right.
has to be something higher
why
it can't be this digressive tactic na this is such an old tactic it's a old textbook tactic take it from here talk about something else Let's talk about the issue. The issue here is the Prime Minister has made repeated statements and he has not acted on them. And that is why, and I agree with Amrita when she says that the reputation of the Prime Minister is at stake here. Remember, the term Mon Modi is not very far away. Manmohan Singh fell from grace because he failed to act. Here is the Prime Minister who can act because there is no other problem. And you're talking about insult to reporters. Don't forget Akash Vijayvargiya's father, Kailash Vijayvargiya, on a news channel asked a news anchor, Tumhari Aukaat kya hai?
Yes.
And I see a reference there, the Prime Minister saying that I don't care whose son he is. I think this is a backhand swipe also at Kailash Vijayvargiya's arrogant attitude when
yes,
he went
but
out
then,
of
but
his
then,
way
you
to
know,
defend
what,
his
what
son
explains the delay in the action, Amrita Binder and then Jitu Patwari. Amrita, I want to come to you. See, we'll quickly put up those graphics once again on the screen of a study in contrast. This is BJP. I'm not even talking about any other party. In Uttarakhand, you've got an MLA called Pranav Champion against whom action has been taken immediately for his high-handedness. He's been suspended for 3 months. But no action taken in the case of Pragya Singh Thakur. No action taken in the case of Akash Vijayvargiya. Why? Simply because they're influential people. Why no action against Akash Vijayvargiya? Why? Because he's the son of Kailash Vijayvargiya, who's delivering West Bengal to the BJP. Is that the fear?
Sanket, when you bring in West Bengal, it would be really great if you could also get some graphics out about the amount of people from BJP cadres that have actually died in West Bengal and have been murdered. So the law and order issue apart, if this is for a debate.
No. My context also, over here
but
was...
coming back to BJP, no,
yes.
I'll take the point. You are all the graphics you're showing are in fact extremely shameful. There is no way that BJP is going to ever be able to suggest that this is something that flies with anybody in India. It can't. So that goes without saying, and this is actually in fact very shaming of BJP. There is no doubt about that.
And I think whataboutry is the last thing that needs to be done here, right?
Yeah, so you know, how much more can I be on the point by saying that this is shameful for BJP? What about me am I offering you?
No.
Second.
That's not in reference to what you are saying. Generally, it seems that the BJP's response at this moment is what about me? That's why.
No,
I think you've been absolutely unambiguous.
No, please understand that you may want to believe that the Prime Minister is a dictator. He's not. He's going to put his recommendations, and in fact, his reputation is on the line. But it is still on the party, and this is the largest democratic party in India. In fact, it is the party right now across pan India. So you've got to have a bunch of people who are from, which are outcome of our society. And if I can tell you, the society is looking pretty sick itself. So as far as BJP MLA needs to be brought to book, I cannot insist enough. It has to happen fast. In fact, it has to happen from the legislature.
Do you think it has happened? Do you think it should have happened before the Prime Minister would have had to remind?
Yes, of course.
I think that's a...
Of course, then the graphics wouldn't need to be played out. This is hurting the party's image. This is in no way good for the party.
That's a fantastic comment that has been made from a youth wing leader of the Bharatiya Janata Party, the Bharatiya Janata Yuva Morcha. I just feel that this voice needs to be heard within the party, lest you become like the very same people you do not want to become or you were challenging. But the other point is Pragya Thakur. How do you respond to that?
One month on and we don't know. Her nomination papers had already been filed. There is no way you could have taken it back, one part. Second is that this whole issue about saffron terror was a bigger point for BJP at that time. In fact, she's become...
We are not talking about saffron terror. We are talking about the very comments for which even the Prime Minister said that I will never be able to forgive her.
Of course, but you have to understand that there was... Why was she brought into politics? Correct. The reason was she was trying to be pitched against the guy who was talking about saffron terrorism from Congress. So that point was to be made. It turned out she's a very big heavyweight to carry. It's become a liability of sorts at a time when the party was going to elections. As far as the disciplinary committee is to come out,
yes.
Of course it must come out with some recommendations. That has to be sent out.
Yeah, it was supposed to come out on the 27th of May. We are still waiting.
Yeah,
Jitu Patwari.
Apologized for a statement.
Jitu Patwari wants to come in. Jitu.
संकेत टू थिंग्स एक तो ये है कि आप ये बताओ कि प्रधानमंत्री जी ने विषय को लेके कहा कि ऐसे जितने भी बेटे हैं या ऐसे नेता हैं उनको किसी न किसी रूप में उन पे बंधन लगना चाहिए पर ये क्यों भूले वो इस पूरे वक्तव्य में कि कैलाश विजयवर्गीय ने जिस तरीके से कमेंट्स किया जो आपने कहा जो सामने आई बात उसको लेके प्रधानमंत्री ने एक शब्द क्यों नहीं बोला कि लोकतंत्र के चौथे स्तंभ को जिस तरीके से क्रिटिसाइज किया कैलाश विजयवर्गीय ने क्या है औकात तेरी हैसियत क्या है ये डिक्टेटरशिप या ये अहंकार है या नहीं है सवाल ये है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी जिस तरीके से पूरे देश में इतने बड़े बहुमत के बाद आई पूरी घटना से स्पष्ट होता है कि अहंकार तो आया है और अहंकार अलग अलग जगह पे अलग अलग तरीके से डॉक्टर भट्ट ने जैसा कहा कि पॉजिटिविटी है कि प्रधानमंत्री ने इसको इनिशिएटिव लिया पर नेगेटिविटी ये है कि प्रधानमंत्री ने इससे पहले जो जो कहा उस पर एक्शन नहीं हुआ और नेगेटिविटी ये भी है कि देश में जिस तरीके से बीजेपी के लोग जीत के बाद इतने अलग अलग जगह पे अलग अलग क्रिटिसिज्म, अहंकार, कट्टरता, हठधर्मिता, धार्मिक कट्टरता,
लेट्स टेक दैट टू डॉक्टर भट्ट. डॉक्टर भट्ट, वुड यू लाइक टू रिस्पॉन्ड? दिस इज डायरेक्ट रिप्लाई टू व्हाट यू हैड सेड.
वेल, you see, I would like to remind Jitu Tiwari ji that just before Lok Sabha election were to take place, there was a massive corruption, you know, there was a... अरे आप सुन लीजिए सर, सुन लीजिए, आपके जो है जो मुख्यमंत्री हैं उनके निजी सचिव के घर में से करोड़ों रुपए पिले थे और उसके इमीडिएटली बाद क्या हुआ, अगले दिन आपने वहाँ के एक विश्वविद्यालय के बहुत सारे प्रोफेसर और पूर्व कुलपति के ऊपर FIR दर्ज करवाई और पूरे पेपरों में छपवाया. यू टारगेटेड द एकेडमिशियंस. दिस इज द लेवल टू व्हिच अ पार्टी विच इज गोइंग, इट नीड्स टू इंट्रोस्पेक्ट इटसेल्फ इज पॉइंटिंग. When you point a finger towards others, please remember the rest are pointing towards your own self.
Sanke, at least how does that answer this
what
question?
What kind of a politics Sanke, you don't Sanke. Even
Dr.
lead
Bhatt,
people
isn't
who are
the Prime Minister attempting to end exactly this?
Let him answer it. Let him answer it. If he has a right to question, I also have a right to question. And this is the truth.
अरे गीता, अरे इतना मत चिल्लाओ, अरे आई कांट हियर एनीथिंग, माय ईयरपीस इज ब्लास्टिंग.
विदाउट एनी प्रूफ.
वन मोर प्लीज.
व्हेन ऑल द पार्टी, व्हेन यू हैव 350, देयर इज नोबडी एल्स टू इंट्रोस्पेक्ट. यू आर द पार्टी इन पावर, स्टॉप शाउटिंग.
संकेत, कैन यू प्लीज
लिसन एंड इंट्रोस्पेक्ट योरसेल्फ. देयर इज नो अदर पार्टी दैट इज लेफ्ट. दे कांट इंट्रोस्पेक्ट बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव एनी मोर सीट्स लेफ्ट. You are the one who has to introspect.
Order, please. Order.
Stop shouting.
Order.
Start introspecting.
I do not represent BJP. I do not represent BJP.
I guess that is only one word.
I think I'll have to.
Please understand. I do not represent BJP.
Hard stop. Hard stop on this little discussion.
Honorable Minister, who is there?
Okay, Dr. Bhatt, Akash Vijayvargiya, Amrita Binder, and Jitu Patwari.
That's all.
Okay. Let's just say. At the end one of the day, I'm Sanket, sure all of us, and I think Sanket, Amrita Binder's voice needs to be heard. She's the youth of the Bharatiya Janata Party. She represents the youth in the Bharatiya Janata Yuva Morcha, the right youth in the right-wing party, and not the wrong youth in Mr. Akash Vijayvargiya, where she's saying that the Prime Minister's reputation is at stake and action needs to be followed. I think that's a very progressive view. With which we are going to end this broadcast. Thank you very much to all you gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. That's a wrap in this edition. News continues right here on NDTV. Stay with us.